Hi my dear student, today we will discuss exercise 1.3 question number 1 option 4. Solve the system of linear equation by matrix inversion method. We have 3 equations and 3 variables x, y and z. Now which where x plus y plus z minus 2 equal to 0. The standard form when you write here, that is x plus y plus z equal to 2. Here 6x minus 4y plus 5z, this minus 31 comes here plus 31, and the final equation 5x plus 2y plus 2z equal to 13, right, in this format. Now the matrix form of the above equation is, first write all the coefficients, x, y, z coefficient, 1, 1, 1, see, 1, 1, 1, here 6, minus 4 and 5, here 5, 2 and 2, variables x, y, z equal to constant value appear in the linear equation of the right hand side, 2, 31 and 13. This is Ax equal to b. We need x, x, y, z. I have A in the left hand side. Take A inverse left on both sides. So A inverse A become I into x is x. And this is A inverse into b. So to find the value of x, just find A inverse multiply with b. To find the value of x, just find A inverse multiply with b. What is A? A is 1, 1, 1, 6, minus 4, 5, 5, 2, 2. Got it? First find out inverse, first find out determinant A. That is 1, 1, 1, 6, minus 4, 5, 5, 2, 2. Expand 1 into minus 8 plus minus 8 plus 10, so minus 10, and this is minus 1, change the sign. 6 2s are 12, 5 5s are 25, change the sign, and plus 1, this is 12, minus 20, change the sign, plus 20, it will be minus 18, it will be minus 13 into minus plus 13, and this is 32. When you subtract, it will be 27, which is not equal to 0. Therefore, A inverse exists. You want to find out, that is A inverse equal to, I will write the formula here. A inverse equal to 1 by determinant A into adjoint A. A inverse equal to 1 by determinant A into adjoint. Determinant A, I got it. Adjoint A. Now finding adjoint A. How to find out adjoint A? Adjoint A is cofactor matrix whole transpose. Cofactor matrix whole transpose. How to find out adjoint A? Find the cofactor matrix, take a transpose. How to find out the cofactor matrix? For each element, leave the respective row and column, expand 2 by 2. Followed by plus minus plus minus plus minus sign, you will get cofactor matrix. After taking cofactor matrix, just take a transpose, it gives the adjoint A. For the first one, see here, I'll do directly this one, leave the row and column, minus 8 minus 10, so minus 18. For this one, 12 minus 25 minus 13, followed by minus this one, 12 plus 20, 32. For this element, leave the respective row and column, 2 minus 2, 0, followed by minus, alternatively plus, minus, plus, minus. For this element, leave the respective row and column, 2 minus 5, minus 3. For this element, leave the respective row and column, 2 minus 5, again minus 3, followed by minus. for this element. Leave the respective row and column. 5 plus 4, 9. And here minus will come for this element. Leave the respective column and row. 5 minus 6 minus 1. For the last element, leave the respective row and column. Minus 4 minus 6 minus 10. Already I explained how to find out adjoint A very detailed in the previous video. When you verify, you can able to understand this one properly. Now, take a transpose. Take a transpose. First row become first column. Minus 18. Minus into minus plus 13. This is 32. Second row become second column. 0. Minus 3. Minus into minus plus 3. Third row become third column. 9. Plus 1. Minus 10. Okay, this is adjoint A. Now, A inverse. What is A inverse? 1 by determinant A into adjoint A. What is determinant A? 27. Adjoint A. Minus 18, 0, 9. 13, minus 3, 1. 32, 3, minus 10. Got it? A inverse equal to 1 by determinant A, that is 27, into adjoint A. Now, you want to find out X. Therefore, what is X? A inverse into B. What is A inverse? 1 by 27, minus 18, 13, 32, 0, minus 3, 3, 9, 1, minus 10. What is B? 2, 31, 13. 2, 31, 13. Always the product of A inverse and B gives a column matrix. I said this is 1 by 27. When you multiply, minus 18 times 2, minus 36, 0 times 31, 0, 9 times 13, it will be 7, 117, 13 times 2, 26, minus 3 times 31, minus 93, 1 times 13. 32 2s are 64, 3 times 31, 93, and minus 10 times 13 is minus 130. 1 by 27, when you simplify, gives 81, this is minus 54, and this is 27, okay, and this is x, y, z. When you divide this 21 here, when you divide this 27 here, 81 by 27, 3, 54 by 27, 2 times, with minus 27 by 27, 1. Therefore, your x is 3, y will be minus 2, and z will be 1. Got it? I'll repeat, the given linear equation, which is not in a standard form, I mean, the right hand side always you need a constant term. So I took this minus 2 here as plus 2, minus 31 as plus 31, 13 already is there. So matrix equation, Ax equal to B, A is the coefficient of x, y, z, x is a variable, B is the right hand side value appeared in the linear equation, and x equal to A inverse B, A inverse formula 1 by determinant A adjoint A. Determinant A 27 not equal to 0, A inverse exists. Adjoint A, find the cofactor matrix, take a transpose, it gives adjoint A, substitute here and multiply with B, and 1 by 27 just leave as it is, don't take inside, just multiply this matrix and the column matrix, it gives again a column matrix. Finally divide the value of 27 here, it gives 3 times and minus 2 times 1 time, it gives the value of x as minus x as 3, y as minus 2, z as 1. How to verify? Just substitute these x, y, z value in any one of the equation. Just verify with whether you are getting the right hand side value. X plus y plus z 2. See, 3 plus 1 4, 4 minus 2 2. Correct. Second equation. 6 times x, 6 times 3, 18. Minus 4 times y, minus 4 into minus 2, plus 8. 5 times z, 5 times 1, 5. It gives 18, 26, 31. So here satisfied. Even you can check with the third equation. also. Even you can, now third equation, 5 times x, 5 times 3, 15. 2 times y, 2 into minus 2, minus 4. 2 into 1, 2. It gives 13. Yeah,
it's correct.